Hello guys, I'll show you how to bleed brake fluid for my Audi S4 B9. If you already know how to do it for other cars, check these notes so that you can skip the rest of this video. Note 1. Use a 10mm wrench for the front 6-point caliper and 11mm wrench for the rear 1-piston caliper. Note 2. Bleeding sequence is left front driver caliper, right front passenger caliper, left rear caliper and right rear caliper. Bleed outer skew and then inner skew of a caliper. Note 3. Total bleeding amount is about 0.2 liter per front axle and about 0.3 liter per rear axle. Note 4. After finish, fill the reservoir to reach or near max level, consistent with the wear condition of brake pads. Still have questions? Continue watching. When to flush brake fluid? The regular schedule to replace whole brake fluid is every 2 years, regardless mileage. Use .4 brake fluid. If you go on tracks, I recommend bleeding only heat-affected fluid after each track day, and bleeding the rest fluid every half or 1 year depending on your fluid quality. Use extreme heat-resistant brake fluid, like Moto RBF 600 and Castrol SRF for track days. Let's get started. Get gloves, eye protector, and N95 mask. Locate brake fluid reservoir under this plastic cover. Check the current fluid level from this side. If it's too low, fill with some new fluid before bleeding to avoid air into holes. Use a funnel or pressure bleeder to fill. Let's check bleeding skews on calipers. Bleeding sequence is left front driver caliper, right front passenger caliper, left rear caliper, and right rear caliper. It's from nearest caliper to furthest caliper. Raise the car and move front wheel. Check my other videos about raising the car. You can see two bleeding skews on this caliper. Audi brake system repair manual says bleeding outer skew first and then inner skew. The order doesn't matter much. We want to see clean bubble-free fluid coming out from both skews, so you can bleed the outer, the inner, and the outer again. Get a brake fluid bottle with high-quality connector. Bottle with a hook or magnet mount is recommended. Mount the bottle to prevent falling. Use a 12.10mm wrench with offset handle for this 6-piston front caliper. Use the 11 wrench for the 1-piston rear caliper. Remove the protective cap. Put the wrench on a bleeding skew. And put the bottle connector. Press hard to seal it. Let's give the brake hose some pressure so that the fluid can go out when we loosen the bleeding skew. Option 1. Use brake pedal. Close the reservoir cap. Get someone to help you press the brake pedal.
Press.
Press the pedal slowly to prevent bubbles. Hold the pedal. Loosen the bleeding skew to let fluid out. Pressure will be reduced and the pedal will drop. Tighten the bleeding skew before the pedal drops too much or before the fluid goes back into the bleeding skew.
Release.
Release the pedal for 2 seconds so that the fluid in reservoir
Press.
Can go down. Press the pedal again and bleed more fluid. Repeat the process to continue bleeding.
Release.
Is there an easier way? Yes. Option 2. Use a pressure bleeder. It will apply pressure from reservoir cap so that we don't have to press brake pedal. Remove reservoir cap, install the adapter, and connect the hose. Increase the pressure to 1-2 bar. Watch the pressure value for a few seconds. It doesn't drop. Sealing is good. You can also use pressure bleeder to fill new fluid. Warning, always check ceiling with air before adding fluid. Release pressure. Add new fluid. Add pressure again. The new fluid will go through the hose. Raise the hose. Release pressure to let air out. Increase pressure again to fill fluid. Release again to let more air out. Repeat the process to fill more fluid. If you couldn't use up the new fluid in the bladder, discard the fluid. Properly estimate the amount to reduce the waste. Don't leave it there for the next bleeding. No matter which option you use, pay attention to the screw sealing. If brake fluid leaks from the connector, tighten the screw quickly and check connection. The leaked brake fluid may damage caliper painting. Absorb it and clean caliper with a brake cleaner. Also pay attention to the brake reservoir. You may pause and check reservoir. If the current level is below the mean level, fill more new fluid before continuing bleeding. Keep bleeding until clean bubble-free fluid comes out and your target amount has reached. Compare levels on the bottle before and after bleeding. Continue for the inner skew. Repeat for the right front caliper, and repeat for the left rear caliper and right rear caliper. Use 11mm wrench for rear calipers. They only have one bleeding screw per caliper. Let's check the reservoir level again. Fill it to reach or near the max level, consistent with the wear condition of brake pads. If your brake pads are new, reach the max level. Otherwise, leave a little room so that it won't overflow when you change the brake pads. Remember to properly discard the old brake fluid. In my city, there are free drop-off events for household hazardous waste. Check your city's waste disposal regulations. That's all. Check my other videos for RDS4 DIY and my track days. Thanks for watching.